What are photo inputs? Photo inputs are the annotations that are placed on photos. This can be a height marker, representing a real-world entity such as cables or equipment, or it can be a photo chip, which is a photo classification. Photo classification is for categorizing photos. This is used to sort them as well as making sure they're associated to the right location. Photo chips are circular icons that appear in the top right corner of a photo. You can create any combination of annotations with height markers, nested height markers, and photo chips. You can access photo inputs during the classification process typically done in photos, or the annotation and cable tracing process done in both maps and photos. You can create your own assemblies or routines that are commonplace in your market, saving a lot of time with annotating photos. To create photo inputs, let's navigate to the model editor. Select your model, then click on the photo input section. To create a photo input, click the blue plus sign button and name your photo input, then click continue. On the left, you'll see an option for adding the photo input to a photo toolset. This is the photo toolset that is available when you click on the black photo toolset chooser icon when annotating photos. You can create your own photo toolsets under the photo toolsets section, where you can name it and decide which photo inputs go into that toolset, as well as what shortcuts they get. Going back to photo inputs, after choosing the photo toolset to add it to, optionally you'll have a space to enter a description for the photo input, as well as a place to upload an example image. On the right-hand side is a placeholder image of a pole. This is where you can build the assembly or routine you want to build. Let's walk through some examples of assemblies you can create in the model editor. In this job, there are a lot of poles with neutrals in neutral tangents, as well as ridge pins with two pins on an arm. So let's start with a neutral tangent. I'm going to put this in the measure photo toolset because we'll be using this annotation with our measurements. If I wanted to, I could add a description of what this photo input is and add an example image of when it should be used. On this placeholder image, I'm going to start building the input. First, we're going to need an insulator. Click on the photo and find the insulator option. Now we're going to right-click on the insulator to open the marker, add an insulator spec, and set that to neutral tangent. Now we're going to add the neutral wire that will go in the insulator by adding a wire and changing the cable type to neutral. We're going to leave the company blank for now so that that can be filled in during annotation. Finally, I'm going to drag the neutral into the neutral tangent insulator and we can click Finish Creating Photo Input. We can also do a similar thing with a neutral dead end. I'm going to click on the photo, look up the neutral tangent we just made, and change the insulator spec to neutral dead end. The last example I'll show is a ridge pin and two pins on an arm. First, I'm going to create the pin. Like the neutral tangent and dead end, I'm going to click on the photo and create an insulator, setting its insulator spec to pin cross arm. Then I'm going to add a primary wire to that pin. Voila! So I'm going to create the ridge pin and two pins on an arm. I'm adding that to the measure tool set, and I'll create an arm and specify that it's an 8-foot cross arm. You can keep it more general by leaving the spec unfilled. Now I'm going to create the pins. Once they're created, I'll nest them inside the arm by dragging them into the marker, the way we did with the wires into the insulator. Sometimes it's easier to open the marker and then drag the other marker into it. Finally, we'll create the ridge pin. And now we can use this assembly in our annotations. For the ridge pin and two pins on an arm, I've placed the pin. The next placement is shown in a card in the top left corner of the photos page. This is telling me that I will be placing a crossarm next. I'm going to hover the crosshair cursor over the crossarm's bolt and click to place it. I can also use my neutral tangent on this pole. Using the photo input for the neutral tangent took me from 10 clicks by manually building it and reduced it to 1 click since I built it in the model editor. That's 1,000 clicks reduced to 100 over just 100 poles. The ridge pin and two on a crossarm was 32 clicks reduced to 2. Photo inputs are powerful time savers. Thanks for watching!